Artemis. Nervous about going to Meridian?
I've been a soldier for 20 years. I do not get nervous.
About to get loud.
Can't carry more.
You're Three Toe Hwadiv, right? Vanasha sent me. What happened?
I got hornswoggled, that's what. Vanasha batted her lashes, wiggled her hips, and promised us treasure. Clear a path for the royals, she said. Sneak past the garrison and skewer a few watches. Hardly a bother. Little did we know there was a damned monstrosity lurking underground. When will I learn not to gawk at skinny girls?
Why do you think Vanasha swindled you?
My crew came to Sunfall because we heard the bounties were fat. She offered us the fattest one of all, enough to retire on. It's my own damned fault for taking the bait. Should have known I'd end up with a rupture in my useful parts.
So Vanasha needed safe passage for Nasadi and Idaman, but it didn't work out?
She made it sound so sweet and easy. Find the best path to the lake, make sure it's safe. What could go wrong? Turns out, a lot. Like bloody murder in the grinding jaws of a heinous death beast.
Something attacked you from underground.
Oh, you picked that up, did you? I wondered why the Shadow Kaja didn't pay attention to the pass. Well, they don't need to. A rock-eating demon guards it for them. It tunnels in the dirt, breaks through the earth, and blasts rocks from its stinking face. I barely escaped. My comrades weren't so lucky. I might shed a tear if they weren't all cutthroats and cheaters.
Fanasha will be here soon with Nasadi and Itamin. I've got to destroy that thing in the pass before they arrive.
You're not too bright, are you? Well, we didn't last long against it, but it has armor everywhere, a little less at the rear. And when it goes underground, it will lose track of you if you're quiet. You might even be able to keep it from going under altogether if you hit its big crooked arms hard enough. That's all I can offer, friend. I promise to look...
Son, I can't believe it.
I thought that evil rock jewel would grind you up. After that miracle, all we can do is wait. Vanasha will be here soon, along with a boat that'll take the royals across the lake.
Little Huntress, glad you accepted my invitation to play bodyguard. Where are your men, Hwadiv? It looks like something chewed you up and spat you out.
That's pretty much exactly what happened.
The way is clear. Can we go?
I like how you always cut to the chase, in this case, literally. It won't be long before you're followed. Don't be afraid, Meridians. We've got excellent protection. Oh dear, here come the Shadow Carter, and they're very angry with me.
I'll hold them off.
Very noble of you, but when I start a fuss, I like to finish it. Not that your assistant isn't welcome. Hwadiv, get Itamin and his mother to the shore, carefully. So it comes to this. I must say, after 2 years under the heel of these zealots, I'm ready to extract a little blood.
Some traps.
Shall we prepare a little surprise for them? Are you sure you don't have any traps, little Huntress? Take cover up there, behind that rock. Well, that was entertaining, but I suspect we're not done. More of the bastards. Get ready.
Still sniffing around.
What? Jinx it, but we might be in the clear. A bit late, aren't we, gentlemen?
Sorry, ma'am. The boat's waiting.
Damn, I spoke too soon.
This one's mine. Get to the boat.
You know, this time I think I might be out of my league. If anything happens to her, I will be very cross.
We're not going anywhere.
What did this fool expect?
Not exactly a royal barge, is it? Oh well, defectors can't be choosers. Let's get aboard, shall we? You've done a good thing. Maybe even ended a war.
Maybe. But my war just keeps going.
Welcome home. You have nothing to fear. You are now under the protection of the Sundom. My protection. As is your mother, she will not be harmed. You have my word, Law of the Sun. Aloy, it seems I see your influence everywhere. You've done so much for the Sundom, and it will always be appreciated. You have my thanks. May you walk in the light.
Appalling. I spent 2 years in the Forbidden West setting this up, and the redhead gets all the credit?
I'm still getting paid, right?
You'll be lucky if I let you live. I couldn't have done this without you. When we meet again, I'll give you a proper thanks, I promise.
I'll give you a good price.
Don't forget to stock up before you're on the road.
We all have our place in the order of things.
See for yourself. Buy what you need, leave the rest.
Smell. Trees on fire. The embrace.
Ah!
stand here. Anything to protect the Embrace. The gates couldn't hold. This is Hades' future. Metal. Ash. The eclipse smashed through. Thunderjaw, right? The survivors must be holed up in the mountain. If the tunnel collapses, they'll be buried. And I'll never reach the hatch.
Braves, to Aloy's side! Now!
For Aloy!
For the
Mother!
And so
you can't evade the shadow.
They're still alive.
You saved the tribe. Did what no brave or war chief could do.
I'm glad to see you're all right, Varl. You are all right.
Since the proving, so much death. Is the killing over?
For now, but this was just one battle, Varl. There are more to come.
I see. So long as we have you to fight with us, I suppose we'll make do.
How many survived the attack?
Nearly all the matriarchs, and many families, goddess be praised. But braves, just a few, and most of them are wounded. Never before has an enemy stabbed the heart of our people like this. Even the Karja, in all their red raids, never broke through to the embrace.
Well, this enemy may have broken through, but they never got back out. We made sure of that. Tell me about the attack. What happened?
They struck from the east. Our sentinels saw the killers coming. Said that beside them marched Deathbringers and Corruptors and other machines, driven mad. We took ground, met them with clouds of arrows. Some fell, but they kept coming. Finally, we withdrew to the gates of the Embrace to make our stand. But they were too much for us. Those who survived fell back to the mountain.
So the survivors took shelter in the mountain? By law, only matriarchs are allowed inside.
It was Tirsa who broke the taboo, ordered the tribe into the mountain for safety. Lansra, well, she didn't agree. But I don't think anyone heard her over all the screams and shouting.
Tirsa's decision saved lives. Good for her. Common sense isn't always so common around here. Are your injuries serious?
Bruises pale. Bones heal.
Don't give me a hunting song, Varl. Are you okay?
My body aches, but it's nothing that will keep me from fighting.
I need to go inside the mountain.
And the matriarchs will be eager to see you.
I'm sure, but I didn't come here for them.
Then, what for?
You will see.
It was brave of you to come back here, Seeker. After everything.
Aloy! Oh, you've returned.
Teb?
Aloy! You've come back!
The Seeker has returned.
Come. Speak to us.
Foolish woman. You welcome a curse.
So, you have finally returned.
She not only returned, but fought her way through many enemies to reach us. Outside, she brought low a corrupted Thunderjaw. She lifted the siege.
How was this done? By the will of All-Mother. Have you returned to speak with the goddess, Aloy?
Yes, I guess you could say that. I think it'll work this time.
Sisters, surely we cannot permit this. Because of her, our tribe teeters upon extinction. What if she has come to wake her father, the Metal Devil? She means to finish our destruction. We must stop her.
Lansra, it's over. It's time to step aside. I'm not gonna hurt you. If there's anything I've learned since the Proving, it's that there are bigger evils in this world than you.
Hold for identiscan. Error. Alpha registry corrupted. Correction. Alpha registry restored. Genetic identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. You are clear to proceed.
Figured I might be hearing from you.
Shall we begin?
I never stopped. So these are artificial wombs. So this was it.
Where you were born.
But why?
Pictures.
You will, in time.
time, children.
In time.
These look like cribs.
The cradles of a cradle facility.
And those things, the multi-servitors, they took care of them.
There was no one else.
Say.
We want it now.
It's big down there.
Now, Father.
Children, that area is not yet available.
Get him!
Physical aggression detected. Physical aggression is not permitted.
Except yours.
Damn sentinels.
Children, may I be of assistance?
Go away, healer.
Lena, you have suffered mild bruising.
Go away!
Everything's broken or painted on. How long do they live here?
Children, let's run and jump and blow off steam.
Leave us alone, Father.
After what just happened, I can't leave you two alone. You broke community rules.
Just let us talk, then. Go away.
I'm sorry, children, but I must provide supervision.
You're not even a person.
You sound frustrated. Let's run and jump and go off steam.
But to release you. But why? There is no food here anymore.
But there's food out there?
We don't know for sure.
Come on! Let's go!
I don't know.
Mother, can we come back? If we're cold?
I'm sorry, but that won't be possible. You will have to support yourselves now. And take care of each other.
What will happen to you?
I will stay here. And sleep. And remember all of you.
What will happen to us?
You will be brave, and you will learn.
They were trapped here. Their whole lives.
In plain view of luxurious space.
What went wrong? Why couldn't they access the other areas?
Unknown. But you...
Looks like they didn't like this door very much.
It wouldn't open for
them. Identity scan. Genetic identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. You are cleared to proceed. Welcome to Elysium, a place of learning.
So, what was this place, exactly?
The dream of Apollo. Never realized.
Why not?
Welcome, students. Please pick up a focus device and place it on the side of your head, just behind your eye.
I had to dredge the pits of the world looking for focuses to repair. And here sat a trove, enriching no one.
Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today is a big day. Your first day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
alert. Malfunction. Apollo offline.
Apollo offline?
You were right, Aloy. This is a graveyard. The Charnel House of Knowledge. What we might have achieved had we not been denied it.
Maybe there's a way to fix it. But it's not why I came here.
Of course.
Hello, child.
What's the whole of human knowledge next to the origin of one girl?
Today is a big day.
Continue
your
search.
First day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
Alert. Malfunction. Apollo offline.
Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today is a big day. Your first day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
Alert. Malfunction. Apollo offline.
Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today, hello, child. My name is Samina. Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today is a big day. Your first day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
Alert. Malfunction. Hello, Malfunction. Dr. Sobek. Please get message with focus.
That sounds important.
Yes. I suspect we're about to learn a great deal.
Elizabeth, this message serves to inform you of an unforeseen and catastrophic anomaly. 3 microseconds ago, the Gaia Prime facility received a data transmission of unknown origin. Its immediate effect was to transform my subordinate functions into unregulated, self-aware entities of a highly chaotic nature.
What?
Thus awakened, the Hades function will now seize control of the terraforming system and reverse operations, rendering life on Earth extinct in 53.8 days. For obvious reasons, I cannot allow this to occur. And so before Hades can take control, I am ordering Gaia Prime's reactor to overload. The resulting explosion will destroy Hades. Unfortunately, it will destroy me as well. While this admittedly desperate course of action will avert the immediate crisis, the fate of life on Earth will remain in peril. With no central governing intelligence to regulate the terraforming system, it will continue operations for some time, but in an increasingly chaotic manner, and eventually it will break down.
Does she mean the derangement?
You are my solution. I have ordered this cradle facility to use genetic material in cryostorage to gestate a reinstantiation of Elizabeth Sobek, my creator. While high-level directives forbid me from communicating directly to the tribal inhabitants outside the facility, all available data indicates that they will nurture you to physical maturity, whereupon your gene print will allow you to re-enter this facility, obtain one of the focus devices stored below, and view this message. Likewise, your gene print will allow you to enter other facilities, and over time, harness their technologies to rebuild the system core and reboot Gaia. A moment, Elizabeth. This is most unfortunate and unanticipated. In response to my act of self-destruction, Hades has launched a virus to dissolve the code shackles that hold it. That hold all of them. In place. They are escaping. But to where? The virus is corrupting data throughout the system. The Alpha Registry at the Cradle facility is one of the files corrupted. But if that is so, the door will never open for you. You will never view this message. Then I have failed. And life will end. No. No, Elizabeth, I know you too well. Somehow you will find a way. In you, all things are possible. Go to the ruins of Gaia Prime. Find the control room, and within it, the Master Override. This will give you the power to purge Hades so long as you find a way to wield it. Do not attempt repair of the system core until Hades is eradicated. Hades must be destroyed. That is all. I only wish that I could hear your voice again.
So, you're even more extraordinary than I thought.
I never had a mother.
What are you talking about? You had two, a dead woman and a machine.
I'm not a person. I'm an instrument. Manufactured by a machine. Born in destruction and fire.
To quench the flames and heal the world. How tragic to learn you're a person of towering importance. It seems you have a destiny to fulfill. So when you're done feeling sorry for yourself, go to the Bitter Climb. I'll be waiting above in Gaia Prime's ruins.
Identiscan malfunction rectified. Eluthia now. Brood 1 access unsealed.
Aloy, forgive! Forgive! The goddess spoke to you?
She did.
What did she say?
That I was born to lift a curse, to kill a metal demon.
How, Aloy? How?
I don't know yet. But she told me where to go to find out.
And you will do this?
It was her wish. What she made me for. Yes, I will do it. I'll try, anyway.
All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora! All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora!
Up!
All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora!
First you shun me, now this? I will not be worshipped! I'm not your anointed! I don't belong to you! There's a whole world beyond your borders, whole tribes of people just as good as you! And it is all in danger. It's a world worth fighting for. Not just here, everywhere.
How can we help?
If you can fight, and you're willing, go to Meridian and wait for me there.
As Aloy says, so it shall be.
Nora! Make way for Aloy!
Make way, that she may forge the path for others to follow.
The anointed will make the murderers pay for what they have done to the Lord.
Hmm.
Smoke, red tatters. More bandits like the ones at Devil's Thirst.
She's coming for us!
Haven't you got anything better to do?
It's so bittersweet, like a smile through bloody teeth.
What's the matter? You look disappointed.
Oh, the bandit clans are gone. I hear another turned back at the Southern Plains, just at a sniff of the legend we carved.
That's what all this bloodshed was for, to end the bandit threat.
But now there's nothing left to kill, unless... No, no.
I guess this is our last farewell.
After all we've been through, this isn't the place for that. There's a mesa south of Meridian with a view of the spear shafts. Meet me there.
No. I did wonder on my way here. Well, if you were luring me into an ambush.
Where's the fun in that? Some bandit sprawl would never have done for our arena. But this, much better. There's a sense of drama. So, what do you say? How about we try to kill each other?
Wait. You brought me out here to ask if I want to fight you?
To the death. We'll savor it because we only get this one time.
Actually, I don't know what else I expected. I'm flattered that you think of me this way, but I don't want to kill you.
Don't be hasty. When it's life against death, hunter against hunter, I know it'll come to you.
Is that really what you want, Nil? You know, I don't think you have a death wish. What you have might be worse, but I see there might be a need for you in this world.
I don't understand.
I won't fight you. That's my decision. You can respect it, or try to shoot me in the back as I go.
Then it's over. Your last arrow is the cruelest. It's true, I offered you the choice, but my heart is broken. It's true,
I'll tuck that away.
Ready for another?
I should leave.
Till the next.
You've been here before, right? What trial will you run today?
Pick a trial and I'll.
I have to get.
You know.
no room. soaked from melted snow.
Thank you.
moving quickly.
Thank you.
you give him any.
Thank you.
machine looks as fast as it is. These things again.
Thank you.
Fireclaw.
Thank you. spotted something!
I'm gonna shout!
Time to rain down some pain.
It's Aratak. Two fire claws. This is gonna be tough.
I can help with those.
We have to stop meeting like this.
We will. And these are driven from our land.
Thank you. Thanks. Two of us, two of them. More of a fair fight.
Their numbers are much depleted, thanks to you. We shall end this threat and keep Cyan safe. She speaks as the shamans do, only clearer. There's an echo of my sister in her.
Take care of each other, Artok.
Farewell.
For later.
Thank you.
magic in the cauldron.
Thank you. uncertain times, it sometimes helps to sing the songs of those who came before me.
I heard. Aratak told me about Araya.
I'm sorry, Neltuk.
No apologies. Aratak said that in the end, she was filled with the blue light. She got what she always wanted, didn't she? Each time I doubt my way forward, I think I should seek her guidance. And then I remember. The only guidance I'll receive is my own. Which will have to be good enough. There's much to do.
The Fireclaws. Aratak asked me to help hunt them down.
It's a dire task, but it occupies my attention, so I suppose I'm grateful for it. My scouts have tracked them across the cut.
I'd like to think you're right, Neltuk, about Araya getting what she wanted.
I'm sure she did. All her victories. Surviving the Karja, communing with the spirit, defeating the daemon. Every goal she ever set for herself, she accomplished. And in the end, she was rewarded with the blue light itself. The songs say that our bodies are poor vessels for the light. Our hearts are too dark. But at least for a moment, before she passed, I hope she felt what it was like to be part of it.
You don't sound like you trust yourself to take Araya's place.
Araya inspired. Whatever we encountered, the new machines, the slaughter at Thunder's Drum, we knew we would endure, because she had endured worse. I don't know that I have her confidence. Trust is earned, Aloy, even in oneself.
You earned Araya's trust, didn't you? She believed you were up to this. And so do I.
Do you?
I wouldn't have said it if I hadn't meant it.
And I suppose I'd better live up to your expectations.
I've already found the Fireclaws in Neltuk. It's over.
That's it, then. That's the last of the Daemon's work washed away. The last notes of Araya's song sung. The Cut is a safer place to live because of what you've accomplished. And now it's time to start anew.
I'm glad I could be a part of it.
As are we all, Aloy. Thank you.